Okay, I'm recording this, so I didn't want to go live and have people asking me a bunch of questions because I don't have time because I'm actually getting ready to go to work. All right, this is a cacao plant fruit. I'm sorry, this is a cacao fruit. This is what is used, the seeds of this is used to make chocolate. So I'm going to show you today how to eat the cacao. All right, I cut it with a very sharp ridge knife down. So that I could open it like this. So that's the inside. Already ate some parts from the other side, and then I was like, I need to show the people how to eat this since I started doing that. All right, so I'm just gonna take one of them out. I'm just gonna show you how to eat it, tell you what it tastes like. It's really good. I did let this one overripe a bit. Only because I buy so much fruit, and then between working, traveling, and stuff, I honestly don't have time to eat everything that I buy. It's crazy. All right. So it's really good. I'm gonna always smile when I'm eating fruit, trust me. So the pulp is kind of stuck to this husk stuff. And you just need time to suck it. Okay, so I'm down to the husk. I'm gonna show you if I can get it off. All right, so this husk is not edible, at least not to me. Ah, nails impede me from doing stuff. One second. I couldn't get it off. Right, I got it off earlier, but I cannot get it off now. Let me see. Here it comes. It's coming. It's coming. Have patience with me. I didn't want to go live again because I didn't have time for questions because I gotta go in here and throw in my uniform and literally run to work for 3 hours and 15 minutes because I didn't give away the last few hours of my shift like a DUMMY. Like, who wants to go to work for 3 hours and 15 minutes? Not I. Okay, so now I'm down to the cacao seed. Or you can taste like a slight chocolatey taste. You can. So when you open it, there's the stuff that chocolate comes from. And if you've been following me at all, you know that I right now am going through this little chocolate addiction thingy. And it's really bad where like I'm eating chocolate a couple times a day. Hormones are evil, let me tell you. But anyway, that's the seed. This is the pulpy thing. Which I can imagine if you're an anxious person. When you go to suck on this and stuff, it can calm you. Because it's calming to sit and suck on this, like really. The benefits of eating this, okay, and there are two columns, one here, and then there's another column underneath it here. When I purchased this, the guy told me he wouldn't eat more than like five or six of these pods at a time because it's medicinal. So I probably already had like seven. So if I start having effects, I don't know. From the medicinal aspect, I'll come back and let you guys know. But it's really good. So this is good for helping you with your memory. What was it? Alexa, what are the benefits of the cacao fruit?
Here's something I found on the web. According to RaiseSpirit.com, studies have shown regular consumption of cacao improves skin texture and microcirculation, improves memory, and increases blood flow to the brain.
Skin texture, memory, circulation, and blood flow to the brain. That's a lot of benefits right there. And you know, people are always asking me, how are you 58 and don't have wrinkles? This is my first time eating cacao, but I eat a whole lot of fruit that benefits, I guess. I have no idea, honestly, because I just made a commitment last January of 22 to take better care of my skin. So now I have like a skin regimen, but and I do stick to it. I have stuck to it since last January. But you know, if you're having skin issues, start researching things that are good for your skin, whether it's in a pill form, whether it's in a natural form, and start eating it. You got to put in the work, people, to get the results that you desire. Nothing about this life is free. And you can't get good skin or healthy or whatever vicariously. You have to do the work yourself. So, there we go. Don't say I never taught you anything. All right. See y'all. Have a good day.